Want to speak real German from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at germanpod101.com.
Hey, what's up everybody? I'm glad you're here. I'm Henrik. Welcome to a new episode of germanpod101.com. Today our topic will be Mars. I will teach you must-know Mars words. And with Mars, I don't mean the Mars planet, I mean math, the subject in school. Only that we Germans sometimes struggle with the TH, so don't get confused here, alright? Let's get started! Number 1. Mathematik. Math. Mein Lieblingsfach in der Schule ist Mathematik. My favorite subject in school is math. Yeah, well, for me actually that counts, because I kind of liked math. It was so logic, it was numbers, it was right or wrong. It couldn't be like German, for instance, where you could say, oh yeah, this is kind of right, but it's also kind of could be seen differently. No, math is cool, math is direct, math is like, yes, it's one or zero. Right or wrong. Number 2. Zahl. Number. Die Zahlen 11 und 17 sind beides Primzahlen. Numbers 11 and 17 are both prime numbers. Yeah, it took me a long time really to understand what are prime numbers when I was a kid. Hard to imagine that I liked math, right? But yeah, eventually I got it, all those numbers which are not dividable except for by itself and by one. So as we're here in my study room, you can see in the background, there's also my keyboard. So whenever studying became a little bit boring for me, I went back there, played a little to distract me from all the studies. So I tried to make it not too boring, not too dry for you guys, even though math is a heavy topic for those who are not so loving with our numbers. But let's just go on. Let's move on. Let's proceed. Nummer 3. Number 3. Einhalb. A half. Ich trinke meinen Tee mit 1,5 Löffeln Zucker. I drink my tea with 1.5 teaspoons of sugar. In Germany, I don't know if you've heard about that, it's quite common to drink tea or coffee also without sugar, without any sugar. Of course, there are people who put sugar in their teas, but I, for example, I like tea or coffee, whatever, even without sugar. And 1.5, it's a lot of sugar, so if I would put sugar, I would maybe would just put a half, einhalb. Nummer 4. Prozent, percent. 50% von 12 sind 6. 50% of 12 is 6. Mathematically correct, German correct, English correct. Easy sentence for you guys, right? Percent, percent. Also sounds very similar to Prozent in German. Prozent, percent. Very similar. Easy one, let's move on. Nummer 5. Nummer 5. Gerade, even. Die Zahl 8 ist ein Beispiel für eine gerade Zahl. Number 8 is an example for an even number. Yeah, as you probably know, even numbers are all the ones 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, which are just even. Don't know a better way to describe it. I personally believe even numbers are more beautiful than uneven numbers, but that's up to you. Nummer 6. Number 6. Ungerade. Odd. Die Nummer 11 ist ein Beispiel für eine ungerade Zahl. The number 11 is an example for an uneven number. Even numbers, no, we have odd numbers. In German, it's a little bit easier. It's just gerade and ungerade. So in many things, if it's the opposite in German, you just put un in front of it. For example, if you measure something really exactly, you say genau. And if it's really incredibly unspecific, not exact at all, it's ungenau. So just put it un in front of the word. Making the meaning the opposite, or making like deny the actual meaning. So, gerade, even, ungerade, uneven, or in terms of numbers, odd. German logic and words is good. Nummer 7. Berechnen, to calculate. Können Sie die Kosten für die Lebensmittel berechnen? Can you calculate the cost of the groceries? Yeah, my grocery costs are not too big, my fridge is always empty. There's not too much to calculate about it. I could maybe eat a little more, then I would also have to calculate more costs for my groceries. Nummer 8. Number 8. Plus. Plus. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 1 makes 2. Super easy one. Just like plus is almost plus. Plus plus. You probably will not get too much confusion with this word. Calculating in German is probably as simple as it is in English for you guys. Number 9. Probably you guessed it already. Minus, minus. 8 minus 1 is 7. 8 minus 1 is 7. Is that too simple for you guys? So let's put 8 minus 5. That's harder. 8 minus 5 is 3. 8 minus 5 is 3. Yeah, you can go on. I mean, I'm probably not the right one to teach you plus and minus. I'm here to teach you the words. And you see minus, minus, almost as simple as plus and plus. Calculating in German, you got it. Number 10, Nummer 10. Mal, times. 3 mal 3 is 9. 3 times 3 is 9. Yeah, there is this, do you know Pippi Longstrump? This, yeah, not cartoon, but child story character. And there's a song, I don't even know how it is in English, but in German the thing, 3 mal 3 macht 9, wie, 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 going on, and so it's like 3 times 3 makes 9, da, 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 da. That's probably the easiest way to remember what is 3 times 3 in case you're not so good with numbers. There's a math rule is in German Punkt vor Strich, means points before stripes, like plus and minus, it's kind of like stripes, whereas mal and geteilt, there are dots. Calculating, if you have a chain of numbers, you always first calculate the dots, the times divided by, before you calculate plus and minus. Why I'm telling you this, just to show we do it the opposite way, we had plus minus, now we have mal. That's already it for our lesson today. If you have any more questions about German or about math, I might be helpful or not. Well, depending on how much you believe in my math knowledge after this lesson. I'd be happy to see some comments of you. Subscribe to the channel GermanPod101.com. Visit the page GermanPod101.com. You will find more videos, maybe even some more spicier than just math and numbers if you're not such a big fan of it. I hope to see you again. I had fun. Bye bye. Auf Wiedersehen.